example. Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online Ayurveda and Yoga workshops, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center. Yoga teacher, I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties and the whole Bhutan. So before recitation, I had to recite some of the common protocols, practices. So even though we are getting vaccinations, please try to follow safe physical distancing and do not touch any surface, as well as do not touch your tongue for any region to count currency or to count papers. And try to always use a double mask or try to protect your facial organs with a facial shield. Next, please remember hand hygiene. Always carry your hand lotions. First priority is clean your hands with soap water. And next one is respiratory hygiene, also very important. Nasal oil applications called Anu Taila or Shadbindu Taila or sesame oil, or you can use cow ghee also. When you know well about this preparation, about these practices, NASA Chikitsa, please do or take advice from the people who already have information about this one. So this is very simple practice, not only in regarding COVID, but it's also good practice for the people who have been suffering from this eosinophilia or some of the phlegm related issues. Next one is gargling by using Estimadu powder or Tripala powder, or you can use plain salt also with acceptable hot water to clean the throat twice or thrice or still more times as per the requirement in a day. Next important thing is steam inhalation. You can use eucalyptus oil or ajwain seed oil, or you can use plain water also, but please remember, please set your device, steam inhalation device, just next to your doorstep, so that before entering your home you can have this steam inhalation. After refreshing, then only you can go inside. So that try to take this method of cleaning the nostrils with steam inhalation as per the requirement, 2 times or 3 times or more than 5 times. Please remember, whenever you are taking this kind of steam inhalation practice, maybe 10 seconds or 15 seconds enough, or 20 seconds enough. No need to do it in a more time. Next one is cloves therapy. Cloves powder and honey also very good preparation to create balance at the throat level against the phlegm level irritations and disorder, especially in management of dry coughs and coughs. This cloves therapy will be very beneficial. And please remember, some of the simple ingredients, Ayurvedic ingredients, which actually came from the herbs called Tripala, Arjuna, Ashwagandha. Next one is Guruchi. These are very simple and effective home remedies to create very good balance in between 3 doshas inside, called Vata, internal wind and internal bile and internal mucus. These are actually, Tripala, Arjuna, Ashwagandha, Guruchi, it comes under food products, it comes under tonics, it comes under medicines also. But you can use these practices as a simple tonic. It's like a everyday energy giving tonic. Energy giving means in the sense of it's not really producing energy, but somewhat it will give good balance in the digestive system, in the blood circulatory system, in the immunity system. That itself also called as a health. Okay, now please remember to follow home kitchen remedies called what we call vitamin A diets and vitamin C and vitamin D, as well as zinc based diets, which are abundantly available in local green leafy vegetables and fresh fruits and milk products, as well as mushrooms and all these things. And also please remember to follow pepper, cumin and cinnamon, ajwain seed and powder. Next one is garlic and hing, jaljeera powder, turmeric, ginger, coriander, and all these are very simple available sources in the kitchen to create very good immunity. Especially it will give functioning application of the blood as well as digestive tract and respiratory tract also. But the way how we are using also very important. Please remember, our food is our medicine, so that do not overtake your food. Please try to maintain that same kind of levels how you are taking as a medicine. And next one is Shilajit. Local Shilajit and local cordyceps also very important. So these are also very good applications in maintaining health and immunity. Take advice from the physician or from the practitioner who already having a knowledge on these 2 applications called local Shilajit and cordyceps. And Kadachai preparation and golden milk preparation also very important to create immunity, as well as it will give that kind of strength to fight against viral cells and bacterial cells and fungal cells, and it will create good balance inside. Next one is Chyawanprash, also a product of nearly 45 different kinds of Ayurvedic plant based herbs. So that please try to have this solution with the hot water or hot milk, or you can consume plain also, but according to your interest, according to your body constitution. If you have diabetes, while using this Chyawanprash, please take care, because some of the variations also having this sweet taste. Okay, now coming to the recitation. This recitation again from the Hatha Yoga Pradipika. It is saying that important about the Bhastrika Pranayam. It's a kind of breathing exercises. Vata Pitta Slashma Haram Sari Ragni Vivardhanam Kundali Bodhakam Kshipram Pavanam Sukadam Hitam Brahma Nadi Mukhe Samasta Kapadhyargala Nasanam. Bhastrika is the name of the pranayama, special breathing practices which imitates the action of the bhastra or bellows and fans the internal fire. This systematic practice of bhastrika starts eradication of excess of wind and excess of bile, excess of mucus, and also it will increase the digestive fire. Basically for the people who are having lower back pains, with a limited way of doing, this will be very useful technique for the people who are having back pains because of vata dosha, because of wind related issues. But please remember the stroke making, how you are stroke making also very important. If you have a severity, based on the severity of the lower back pain, some people may not attempt this Bhastrika Pranayam, but some people may attempt this Bhastrika Pranayam. Always better to take an advice from the yoga teacher who are having good medical knowledge in this health regard. Okay, now in this week we are seeing some of the simple practices for the back pain management. So here back pain in Ayurveda, also called as Kati Sula, causes may be shocks or accidents. Important thing is our body postures and our jerks and forward bends while doing our regular activities, and overstrain and improper exercises and obesity, sports and adventurous games. Somewhat it's a kind of imbalance in the sports and weightlifting, weight management, and pregnancy related issues and geriatric problems and old age problems and sleeping positions. Whatever causes will be for the low back pain or lower back pain or mid back pain, above back pain or neck rigidness. Symptoms will be common symptoms, first of all pain and rigidness and inactive life, as well as uneasiness, and some people may have insomnia, sleeplessness also. But try to avoid overeating and try to maintain your body weight in proper way, and try to avoid tubers in the food, or lower the tubers and the salts and carbs, and try to maintain a proper way of physical exercises while doing your regular activities. But that's very simple and very effective remedy, is maintaining your body weight and maintaining proper way of exercises. Then here another way, long time sitting, long time standing, long time driving, these are also killing factors for the lower back pain and back rigidness. Still we have, if the people who are having these lower back pains, especially the people who are at the age group of 40 to 70, many of these people may get these back pains because of wind related issues or vata dosha. For them we have in Ayurveda very simple solutions, medicines called Vata Vidvamsani Ras, Maha Masha Taila and Narayana Taila, and next one is Vata Harini and Maha Vata Vidvamsini. These are some of the internal and external applications. Also we have in the name of Gugulu, we have many important simple practices called Gokshuradi or Lakshadi or Amrutadi or Swarna Mahayogi Raja or Mahayogi Raja, Yogi Raja Gugulu. These are simple applications in Ayurveda, in the pharmacy segment. In the therapeutical also we have good practices called Kativasti or Sneha Karma or Svedana Chikitsa, Panchakarma Chikitsa or Sarvangadhara, also very simple and effective remedies in Ayurveda which will create good balance at the backbone issues. And today's Ayurvedic advice, home Ayurvedic advice is please try to collect some of the oils called sesame oil. It's a kind of massage, sesame oil massage at that affected area. It's a kind of fermentation or heat up, take one cloth and heat that cloth with hot water and just apply that cloth after soaking in the sesame oil on the affected area of the lower back or mid back or above back pain. So next one is edible camphor oil. Edible camphor is also available for especially edible camphor oil. So again, this is also for massaging technique, and castor oil again for massaging technique, as well as vitex nigundi or nirgundi oil also again for massaging technique. Or you can combine all these oils, like 20 grams of nirgundi, 20 grams of castor oil, 20 grams of sesame oil, 20 grams of edible camphor oil. Try to mix with the like a limited quantity of water, and try to fermentation. It's a kind of heating up that area with a soaked cloth, heat cloth. Very simple preparation. Morning once, afternoon once, and evening once, and before your sleep also you can do this simple preparation, or you can keep a hot bag also on that affected area. This is external therapy, but very good therapy. So when we are meeting here with the same content, at the same place tomorrow, we will see good applications in Ayurveda as well as in yoga also. Yeah, let's join today's yoga class now. And please remember, in any kind of physical activity, yoga, physical postures, or your gym activities, or martial art activities, or sport activities, avoid forward bends or avoid sudden jerks or sudden moves. When you have lower back issues, or when you have already like a track of this lower back issues. Okay, take a long, slow, and a deep inhalation, exhalation. So sun salutation is our regular practices. Lift your both the arms up, pranamasana above to the head. And very slowly, pranamasana down at your chest level, called pranamasana, anahata pranamasana. So here we have mantra chanting, sloka, bija akshara, according to your traditional belief. So you can follow, or you can follow only physical practices. Om hiranmayena patrena satyasyapi hitam mukham tatvam pushan apavrunu satya dharmaya drushtaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Hraim Haum Raha Mitra Ravisurya Bhanu Kagapushna Hiranya Garbhamaricha Aditya Savitra Arka Bhaskaraya Namaha. And stretch your arms forward, lift your arms up, and once completely stretch and pull the body up. So here we have another back bend, Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakra, according to your convenience and flexibility and experience. Just move your body back as a bend, or then come back. Keep your body straight. Now again, pull up. And here, if you have lower back issues or above back issues or neck related issues or face related issues or blood fluctuation related issues or heart ailments, please try to avoid all types of forward bends in the regular activities also. And then completely, remaining people completely bend the body forward, called Padahastasana. And right leg is your back leg, called Aswa Sanchalanasana, horse riding posture. And right back leg straight on the toes, forward leg joined to back leg, called Dandasana. And here very slowly bend the body forward towards the floor, called Ashtanga Namaskarasana. Like a sea wave, lift the body. And try to attach your body, called Bhujangasana or lifted head cobra posture. This is very simple and effective home remedy for the people who are having lower back pains, especially Bhujangasana. And right, back leg straight, another way of forward bend, another way of like a semi-inversion posture, called Parvatasana. But the people who are having health related issues, don't follow the next exercise. And completely press your heels down, push your body inside and stay. And right leg is your forward leg, again called Aswa Sanchalanasana or horse riding posture. And right back leg straight on the toes, and back leg knee up, join your back leg to the forward leg, called Padahastasana or standing forward bending. And lift your both the arms and body up, Hasta Uttanasana. And here slightly put a back bend, Ardha Chandra or Ardha Chakrasana. Again keep your body straight, pranamasana above to the head. Then very slowly pranamasana down at your chest level, called Anahata Pranamasana. And lift your both the arms up, and very slowly wide your both the arms, then slowly bring them down at your thighs. Alright, soon after your practices, once give relaxation to the body and lock your hands back, keep your body straight and adjust your legs, give a small gap in between your legs, and take a long, deep, slow inhalation and exhalation. Alright, and now keep your body straight. So today also we will do some of the simple and effective practices which will be give benefit to everyone, not only for the people who are having back issues. Alright, take a long slow inhalation and exhalation. Alright, keep your both the legs slightly wide, and here lift your both the arms up. Then after that, interlock your fingers and attach your interlocked arms behind the head, and wide your elbows, completely wide your elbows. So lift your chest and lift your chin up and slightly put a back bend. This is simple Ardha Chandrasana variation. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 relaxation. Then very slowly come back. So today's exercises maybe it will give benefit to the people who are office goers also, because office goers are the people they are spending more time while sitting on the chairs, and their body is going to be crooked or crunched and hunched back. For them also, this is very simple and effective practices. Okay, take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. And next exercise is the same Ardha Chandrasana, other variation. So keep your right leg back, left leg forward, right leg back, left leg forward. But when you have knee issues, try to keep your knee tight with the kneecaps or any other equipments. Alright, try to push your body slightly forward on the base of the forward leg squat, forward leg bent. So try to lift your back leg heel up. So here also lift your both the arms forward. Then here interlock your fingers behind the head. Then try to keep a stretch on the back and try to give a more stretching and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then very slowly keep your body straight. Then lift your both the arms and keep your forward leg straight, and slowly join your two legs for simple relaxation practices. Pose stretches immediately after every yoga pose. We should do some of these stretches in the segment of pose stretches. And opposite side, the same exercise, change your leg. So this time, right leg is your forward leg, left leg is your back leg. So try to lift your back leg heel and bend your forward leg. Here also, interlock your fingers behind the head. Then completely push your body on the forward leg base and lift your chin up. So this is very simple exercise for the leg stretching as well as pelvic stretch as well as back bending also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 relaxation. Chin up and slowly stretch. And keep your arms down and legs together once. Give stretches to the back and to the legs. Take a long, slow inhalations and exhalations. Alright, now try to sit properly on the mat in folded leg variation or any convenient and comfortable posture. Okay, take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. So like when you have no issues in the knee level, then try to keep your both the arms slant back. So to cover this kind of postures, I'm requesting my video officer to come to my right side or left side. Then right. And keep your both the arms back, then try to adjust your hands and lift your chin up. Very simple and effective remedy for the lower back pain. And few seconds stay here. 1. So in this same exercise, when you have good flexibility, when you want go for more back bend, just to try to lift your hips up and give a stretch at the neck level and give a push at the abdomen level and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly come back, release, and very slowly relax. Alright, take again long and slow and a deep inhalation and exhalation. So most of the time today we are doing back bends, but as a counter pose we can do forward bends also. But at your free time you can choose any one forward bend, but we will do forward bend in the ending. Then here slowly stretch your both the legs forward. The same back bending called Sukha Dandasana, very simple and very effective practice. So both the legs stretch forward. So here open your both the arms back and slant your body. Here on the base of the hands, on the base of your thighs, just lift your chest, expand your chest and lift your chin up and completely hang your head back and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 relaxations in up, then slowly strides come back. Then again long and deep and slow inhalation and exhalation. Alright, very slowly turn on the mats, but spread your body on the mat, like turn on the abdomen, is kind of pronal postures. So try to keep your both the heels inside and toes outside, and both the palms inside under your right cheek or left cheek, properly place them, and few seconds relaxation. So this is itself a very simple and effective posture called crocodile resting posture or Makarasana. And then very slowly keep your both hands inside and pre-position for the actually coming activity. Then after that, very slowly push your body up like a lifted head cobra, still up, and try to keep your one elbow point down on the floor and second elbow point also properly joined to the first elbow. Try to place your chin on the above two opened palms and few seconds stay now. So this is also a variation in Makarasana, also we can call as Niralambasana. So but few seconds stay, observe your lower back position while doing this simple exercise. This posture also good for the people who are having neck related issues. And here, do not hold the breath and take long, slow and deep inhalations and exhalations. Then after a while, then very slowly keep your right hand down and left hand down. Try to put your forehead on the floor. Then after that, try to interlock properly on the head and stay now. Alright, then slowly strides come back. And now we are doing Bhujangasana, one of the variations in Bhujangasana. So here only lift your head and chest up to your spine only. Don't lift your palms, don't keep your elbows straight. Your elbows must be placed on the floor. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then very slowly relaxations. Again keep your forehead down and lock your head with your two hands. Then slowly come back. So today's we have last posture is somewhat variation in the Shalabhasana. Wide your both the arms on the side stretch. Then keep your chin on the floor. Then try to put your lift your right leg up to the left side, completely turn your body. So when you have good flexibility, you can catch your right leg with the left hand to pull the leg more. Here observe your stretch at the hip level and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, then relaxation, then very slowly come back. Take a long deep inhalation and exhalation. And after quick recovery time, then same thing here, try to adjust your both the legs, check your dress, check your mat, check your breath, and especially check your neck convenience. And after that, counter pose, opposite side, same thing, lift your leg up and completely drop that leg, opposite side. Again here, few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, very slowly release your leg and relaxation. Enough. Then soon after this practice, try to put your any relaxation posture, Makarasana or any posture. Again here few seconds take inhalations and exhalations. And to counter all these poses, we have only one forward bend, very simple and effective forward bend that can be performed by everyone. So properly sleep. Please remember, if you have lower back issues or above back issues, this Shavasana itself a kind of not very good posture for you, because here lower back is not really touching the floor. So that immediately after your sleeping activity, fold your leg and try to keep your both the legs as pillars, and this is itself called Stambhasana. So here in this posture, many people will get a very simple relaxation, very good benefit. Alright, and now try to take a long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. After that, keep your right leg on the abdomen, left leg on the abdomen. So here still you can observe the total lower back is now on the floor. And now here close your press your abdomen with your both the knees, and after that, if you have neck issues or neck related issues, don't do the next exercise unless remaining people can interlock your fingers under the head or under the neck. Under the head or under the neck. Just lift your head up and few seconds bring your knees towards the abdomen and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and relaxations. Enough. And slowly keep your head down. Then after that, again slowly keep your legs down to attach the Stambhasana, knee lifted posters, vertical knee posters. And from here, open your right leg, stretch on the floor, and after that, left leg stretch on the floor. Then slowly wide your arms and legs, long, slow and deep inhalation and exhalation. Then after that, keep your both legs together and towards your right side or left side, turn the body. And few seconds stay here. Then after that, with the help of your hands and legs and limbs, and lift the body and get up and sit down. Okay, and now coming to pranayama practices. So before pranayama also, we have like chantings of mantra and bijakshara and the sloka. When you have your traditional belief, you can follow the chanting, or you can follow only physical activity, physical practices. Like after a small gap, now starting your pranayama practices. So it is also advised to drink a sip of water for mantra chanting before your pranayama. Okay, long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Om Kesavaya Swaha. Om Narayanaya Swaha. Om Madhavaya Swaha. Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyattham Asana Purvakam Pranayama Diyam Karishye. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Alright, keep your hands down. Long, slow inhalation. So in other words, it is saying that yoga practices purpose and pranayama purpose and mudras and bandhas, some of the advanced hatha yoga practices including meditations and dharana activities, all these purpose is not only maintaining immunity or anti-aging or longevity or physical health. So it has a definite purpose, it's a definite goal called spiritual upliftment. To reach that level, one should be aware of the physical body health and mental health and social health. And coming to next exercises, so next exercises also we have. One is Kriya Abhyas and second one is Pranayama. And try to choose any good surface to sit in any convenient posture. Right, take a long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. So here we have Kapalabhati first exercise. Vastrava loha karasya recha purav sasambhramau kapala bhatir vikyata kapadosha visoshini. So it has mentioned in Hatha Pradipika that kapadosha visoshini, whatever phlegm related issues inside the body, inside the skull, that will be totally eradicated. And also it is itself called as kapala bhati. Kapala means the total skull and facial organs. Bhati means prakash. In physical levels, somewhat physical like facial organs will get good benefit because of kapala bhati, stroke making, or because of like overflow of blood. Next practice is called Surya Bhadana Pranayam. It is also saying that kapala sodhanam vata doshaknam krimi dosha hrut punaha punaha idam karyam Surya Bhadana Muttamam. Like it will check the wind related errors, internal wind related errors throughout the body, especially face and skull. And it is also saying that vata dosha gnam, like it will be good exercise for the people who are having this wind related issues, over wind related issues. And also saying that krimi dosha hrut, it will give the abdominal warmth also, but the way how we are doing very important, because every pranayama must be performed with the mudras and bandha, some of the retention practices in the pranayama. Because of our online participants, in the view of beginners, we are not creating any tough exercises. But whenever you have good time to interact with your yoga teacher, so try to take this elevated practices from them. Okay, take a long, deep, slow inhalations and exhalations. And here, Kapala Bhati Kriya Abhyas, we are doing 30 strokes in 3 spells, and first spell will be only 10 strokes. Keep your positions right and keep your backbone right. And starting
9, 10. Okay, one long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. And second spell starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, long, slow, and deep inhalation, exhalation. Okay, third, last stroke, making 10 strokes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, one long, slow inhalation, exhalation. But please remember, when you have any sickness related to blood circulation system or vertigo or throwing sensations or any issues with the in the ear, like, do not try to attempt this kind of Kapalabhati or Bhastrika practices which are having stroke making inhalations and stroke making exhalations. And coming to Surya Bhedana Pranayam, it's itself called as right nostril inhalation, left nostril breathe out. Okay, now here open your right hand, last two fingers and right hand thumb, and try to turn towards your face. Obviously, your right nostril will receive your right thumb and left nostril will receive your last two fingers of the right hand. Then here close your, take a long deep inhalation, exhalation. After that, close your left nostril and inhalation with the right nostril. And slowly complete breathe out with the left. Again, right nostril, breathe in. Left nostril, breathe out. Right nostril, breathe in. Left nostril, breathe out. Fourth count inhalation with the right nostrils. And left nostril, breathe out. Last count, right nostril, breathe in. And slowly complete breathe out with the left. And slowly keep your hand down, take a long, slow and a deep inhalations and exhalations. Again, long, slow, deep inhalation, exhalation. Once you have finished your pranayam, so like if you know well about the dharana practices or concentration practices in the Trataka format, so please try to perform. And after that, try to do these practices, yoga nidra or power nap practices also, to regenerate the body and mind. So once you are able to successfully finish your total yoga workout, take 15 minutes time to half an hour time. This time will be totally depend on the people to people and practice to practice at strength level and intensity in the practices. And take 15 minutes to half an hour time to take bath as well as further 10 minutes time to take breakfast. And in the afternoon, before your lunch hour, again try to see all the possibilities how to do a power nap or yoga nidra to regenerate yourself as well as to give extra focus to the mind to concentrate on the further works. In the evening, once you will be totally free from your all activities and efforts, before your dinner time, again try to create 15 minutes time to half an hour time or still more time according to your flexibility and timings to do your self yoga exercises, and including back bending exercises, including breathing exercises, and including inversion postures also. Tomorrow morning when we are meeting here at the same place with the same content, we will see good applications in Ayurveda as well as good practices in yoga also. Thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity. Stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thank you.